Boy, Russ, this is a follow-up to my Get Out and Ride More video. Another good reason to get out and ride more. This is just my personal experience. I don't know if there's any sort of study that's been done or any sort of empirical data that will verify what I'm about to say to you, but this is my opinion. Opinion only, like everything else in these videos. The more you ride, the better you are at riding, the more comfortable you are on the bike, the safer you're going to be on your bike, and the more you're going to enjoy that ride. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I went through a stage where I rode my bike pretty much every day for a year. And in Florida, you get all types of weather conditions. Okay, you don't get freezing conditions, but for us it's freezing. 30s, the 20s, rain, really sweltering heat, horrible traffic, nighttime riding, everything you can imagine I'm exposed to. And I'm riding my bike and controlling and manipulating the controls on a regular basis every single day. And so your reflexes are better, your control, your mastery of your bike is better because you're doing it more often. It's like anything you do. It's like going out and shooting. If you go out and shoot, and you might be a good shot at one point, you know, but if you're not shooting very regularly or you're doing it infrequently, guess what? Your skills are going to erode. It's a perishable skill. Motorcycle riding is the same thing. Well, it's very similar. You need to do it more often, or you need to do it frequently to keep that level of skill up. So, maintain your skill level. And you know, I was kind of anally retentive. I would do things like I would practice slow speed maneuvering in parking lots, empty parking lots. I would practice braking and swerving, emergency braking, really hard braking with both the front tire alone, front and rear tire. I would practice just a lot of different things, you know, as I went on, because I want to improve my skills. Why? Because I know that this is one of those hobbies, because right now it's not a necessity for me to ride right now. I don't have to ride now. Yeah, I had to before, but I don't have to now. And it's one of those hobbies that can be potentially dangerous, especially in Florida. Think about it. I've got colleges near me. I've got Rollins College. I got UCF not too far away. So you got college students that are either drunk, high, late for class, late for work, driving pizza delivery or whatever, sandwich delivery service they're doing, they're driving Uber and they're late, or their significant other called them up and said, hey, come over and get some booty, and they're going on that booty call and they want to make sure they get there as quickly as they can, because you know how it is, especially dudes. I'm a dude, so you know, especially dudes, you know how we get. You're like, oh, wait, booty, okay, yeah, I'm there, you know what I mean, I'm all about booty. And so then there we go, and guys just wind up putting themselves in a bad position, or put you in a bad position. One of the worst things I've ever had to do was stalled my bike. That's horrible. See, it's that down low. I got some hesitation on the throttle, and I gotta really ride the clutch out to let it open. I still smell that smell. You know how you get that burning almost smell? That's what I'm getting right now from it. So I'm pretty sure either I got an issue with fuel injection, or it's because the bike's been sitting down for so long, not being ridden, that's causing the issue. But anyway, that was an embarrassing thing. I'm not going to edit it out. It's going to be in there. It's going to be in the video. I'm a decent rider, but I messed up there. So the more often you ride, the better you are. The more you're riding endurances. And I'll give you an example on that. Like bike week type things. Guys that go to bike week typically dust their bikes off once a year for bike week and Biketoberfest down here. You have two different things, bike week, Biketoberfest, both really great. Not as fun as they used to be, because Volusia County has kind of made it kind of an unfriendly atmosphere for the bikers. And so the bikers are kind of taking their act up the road to Flagler. But it is what it is. It's still going to truck on. And, you know, they don't ride their bike. They're sitting there, because most of these guys are attorneys and, business owners, entrepreneurs, surgeons or whatever it might be, accountants. And then, a month before bike week, they grow a goatee, Velcro on a fake ponytail or something like that, dust off their bike, and then they're gone. And they're out there. They're Mr. Bad Boy Biker. You see, hear that? Low down in the rev range, little bit of juddering. So the injection, man. Hear that? It's not supposed to sound like that. It's still running okay, but definitely have to get this taken, looked at. Either that or I need to go for a new long ride and maybe get some gas. Who knows? Maybe putting some gas in it will help it. I don't know. Hear that? Sounds almost like a 250 coming out of there. So we'll see. But ride your bikes more often. Makes you safer. Makes you a better biker. Anyway, that's my rant for now. I'm going to go get some gas. It's your boy Russ. I'm out.